Okay, ladies, we're back. This is video two for the Easy Fingerless Gloves Knit Along. You all must have finished up to the place you want to put your thumb on a stitch holder. So I'm going to go ahead and do row 19. We are on row 19, okay? Just go ahead and do row 19. Get my needle one in place. Okay, so knit 13. So I'm going to go ahead and knit 13. Okay, I knit 13, knit in front of back of next stitch. So we're going to knit into the front and into the back of this next stitch. Remove marker, remove my marker. Now place the 14 stitches on a stitch holder. I usually just use a piece of scrap yarn for my stitch holder for my thumbs. So I'm going to put these 14 stitches on this scrap yarn. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. There, that's my stitch holder. Okay, now remove marker and knit into the front and the back of the next stitch. Let's kind of get this up there. Okay, so I'm going to knit into the front and the back of this stitch. Like that. Okay, and then knit to the end of the round. So I'm going to turn my work over, get my needle two in place to knit. And I'm just going to go ahead and knit these stitches off of needle two to complete round 19. Okay, now after you finish row 19 or round 19, that means the same thing, go ahead and continue in stockinette stitch. I've got 2.5 inches more to knit to match my glove, but if you want yours longer, just go ahead and knit as long as you want your top of your gloves to be. And then you're going to go ahead and purl one round, knit one round, and bind off, okay? So now I should be back to my original 17 stitches per needle, so let's make sure. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yep, we're good. I'm golden. Okay, now I'm just going to go ahead and knit in stockinette stitch, knit off a needle one and then two, one, two, all the way up until I have 2.5 more inches. And then I'm going to purl around and then knit around and then bind off. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that now, and then we'll come back and we'll pick up these stitches to place the thumb. Okay, so go ahead and do that. I'm going to turn the camera off, and I'll see you in a few minutes when I'm done. Okay. Hi, I'm back. I'm ready to pick up the stitches for my thumb. I knitted up my 2.5 inches, and then I purled around, I knit around, and then I purled around, and then I cast it off. While I was doing the garter stitch edge, I noticed on the pattern that I didn't have the last purl round written there, so I went ahead and fixed that. So go ahead and write that in the pattern if you've already printed it off my blog. So what it should read is knit and stockinette stitch for 2.5 inches, purl one round, knit one round, purl one round, and bind off. I did make the correction on the blog, so it's correct right now. So there you go. Okay, so we're going to pick up these stitches for the thumb, and all you do is take your circular needle and place these 14 stitches right on the circular needle, just like that. I have my 14 stitches from my thumb. Let's make sure. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Yes. Okay. Now I'm just going to knit straight. So I want to start with the right sides facing. And this is the right side. So I have to bring this over here, just like that. And I'm going to knit back and forth. I use my circular needle as a straight needle. So, okay, there we go. Right sides facing. I picked up the 14 stitches. Now I'm going to add my yarn. I'm just going to start knitting. Just like that. Just put my yarn. Just add, go ahead and just add the yarn just like that. It's no big deal. And then knit. Ooh, I almost dropped that one. Okay. Let's make sure I got my 14, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Yep. Okay, now I'm going to turn this around and I'm going to purl. And I'm just going to go back and forth, knitting and purling. I'm knitting in stockinette, and I'm knitting straight. I'm not knitting in the round anymore. And then I'm going to go ahead and continue this. I'm going to knit on the right side, purl on the wrong side until my thumb measures about an inch. And you guys do it as till you want to stop. Your thumb is as long as you want. And then go ahead and purl around, knit around, and purl around, and then bind off. And then you'll weave in your ends, seam up your thumb and weave in your ends, and you'll be good. Okay? Okay, I'm going to shut this off, and I'm going to knit for about an inch, and then I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. I knitted for an inch on my thumb. And according to the instructions, let's go ahead and read that. Right where it says thumb, pick up the 14 stitches from stitch holder with circular needle, which is what we did. Or you can use a straight needle. It doesn't matter because you're working back and forth. And then you will now be working back and forth, not in the round. With right side facing, knit in stockinette stitch until thumb measures 1 inch, ending with a wrong side row. Okay, that's what we just did. And when it says ending with a wrong side row, that means you finished working that wrong side row. So the right side row is now facing you, okay? When it says ending with the wrong side row, that means you finished that row. When it says ending with right side row, that means you finished knitting that right side row and you're facing the wrong side. So we ended with a wrong side row, which means we finished the wrong side row, and now we're on the right side row. And we want to make our garter stitch edge, so we're not going to knit this. We're going to purl this row. So I'm going to go ahead and purl. these 14 stitches. Okay. Now I'm on the wrong side row, but I'm going to knit, not purl, because I want to make that garter edge. Okay, now the instructions say to purl one more time, so we're going to purl this round, this row here. Okay, so we just made our little garter ridge there on the thumb. I'm going to go ahead and bind off. I'm sure you guys all know how to bind off, but just in case there's somebody out there that just would like a little refresher on binding off, we're just going to go ahead and bind off here. So you just knit a stitch, and then you knit another one. So you have two stitches on the needle. You take that first stitch, and you pull it up and over the second stitch. Now you have one, you bound one off. We're just going to continue that across this row. Okay, now I got one more stitch left on the needle. I'm just going to go ahead and pull that like that, take my needle out, and thread my yarn through that last stitch to secure it, just like that, and pull that like that. Okay, there, you just bound off your thumb. Okay, now all you're going to do is thread this yarn here and sew up your thumb. Just like that. Okay? We tuck this right down in there. I'll just weave that in when I'm all done. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to sew up the thumb so you guys can either shut the camera off and sew up your thumbs, or if you want a little tiny refresher, this is how I sew up my thumbs. Okay, just go over here and grab the other side there. And I'm just going to go back and forth from one side to the other. Just like that. Oh my goodness, I don't know if you guys could have seen that. I just noticed I was out of the camera. Just go from one side to the other. In the last video, the MM Mittens knit along, that might have a little better seaming up of the thumb here, because it's getting dark here. It's night. It's getting evening here, and I can't see that good, so I'm not sure if you guys can see this or not. I'll put a link to that on the blog. Okay. Okay, then what I'm gonna do is just tighten this up a little bit. Then I would put my needle down inside my thumb, turn my thumb inside out, and close up any little holes I might have right here, and then weave in my ends. And that should do it. I hope you guys can see this okay. There you go. There's your two mittens. Have a great day. Bye-bye.